Запись идет?
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Всем привет!
Всем привет!
Мы уже почти 3 месяца снимаем онлайн-собрание, и сегодня решили с вами поделиться некоторыми забавными моментами. Итак, начнем. Первое видео.
Неважно, где ты сейчас находишься, возможно, в компании друзей, в КД-группе, может быть, дома с семьей, или ты изолирован от других.
Я буквально воспринял фразу «ты можешь быть где угодно» и просто решил встать прямо перед камерой. По-моему, это очень прикольно.
Это было первое собрание, мы косячили как могли.
Итак, смотрим второе видео.
А сейчас у нас будет большое слово. Давай вместе повторять движение.
А ты знаешь все движения нового большого слова?
Да, я знаю все движения большого слова. Большое слово — это очень круто.
Это правильно, потому что по-другому в детское не пройдешь. Окей, давай следующее видео.
Будем восклицать вместе с псалмопевцем Давидом. Аминь. Я сейчас умру.
На самом деле стезя проповедников — это действительно очень сложно. Поэтому респект всем проповедникам в нашей церкви. Все, кто проповедует, ведут канал-группы. Ребята, респект вам. Итак, смотрим следующее видео.
Давай. Ну, что тут скажешь, как не...
Точно.
Андрюха, будь здоров. Хорошо, давай следующее видео.
Получилось? Я знаю, что нет, друзья. Оп! Да что ж такое, я правда не могу. Это очень сложно.
Да, самое главное помнить то, что... у вас все получится, и лучше еще впереди. И даже если у вас не получается делать челленджи на детских собраниях, все будет круто. Итак, следующее видео.
Настоящий мужик, настоящий мужик. Я хочу спать.
Эй, Вовс, ты можешь как-то объяснить, что происходит на этом видео?
Я вроде бы все объяснил в конце. Шел 12-й час съемок, поэтому...
А, это все объясняет. Ну что же, друзья, во-первых, всем просто респект тем, кто участвует в подготовке собраний. Ребята, вы молодцы, вы просто лучшие. И я предлагаю сейчас всем писать в чат, какой фрагмент вам понравился больше, какая часть больше повеселила. И что ж, до новых встреч, всем пока.
Всем пока.
Good morning, Church. Welcome to Hillsong Church Online Service, and we're happy to have you if it's your first time. Please stay until the end. We hope it will be a blessing for you. You can also subscribe to this channel. I hope you're well, and I wanted to offer us to pray together at the beginning of, and pray for each other, for the church, and also pray for the needs and challenges that are in our lives. Some of the prayers that people wrote and submitted on our website or in social networks can now be seen on the screen, and let's pray now about each of these prayers. Let's proclaim God's victory, let's proclaim salvation, let's proclaim God's healing in each person's life. Let's pray collectively. Just before we pray, I just want to remind you that over the past few months, we have seen so many wonderful testimonies and so many people are thankful in the lives of ordinary people when God did miracles. You know why? Because the church constantly prayed and God answers the prayers of people. God answers prayers of church. You know, prayer has power. So let's pray all together now. Dear Heavenly Father, we love you. We proclaim your mercy and your grace, your defense over everyone's life. We проклаим healing. We проклаим salvation. We проклаим answers from heaven in the lives of people in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we проклаим recovery in people's lives in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Thank you also for posting praise reports on our website, and some of these are on your screens now. Thank God for everything He does, even in such a difficult time as now. And I would like to say that we're going to worship all together now. Let's make this time special in our homes. Let's sing, let's expect that God will fill our homes, our cars, with the Holy Spirit, wherever you are now. In the name of Jesus, Amen.
Церковь, привет! Перед тем, как мы будем вместе сегодня поклоняться, я бы хотела ободрить нас. Мы все проходим иногда разные периоды, наше сердце иногда нуждается в утешении, в заботе. И, может быть, какие-то терзания и муки бывают в нас. Точно так же, как у царя Саула, когда ему было плохо, мы знаем, что он просил Давида, чтобы тот приходил к нему и пел для него какие-то песни. И его сердце, оно восстанавливалось в те периоды. И, знаешь, я думала о том, что песни, которые звучат вокруг нас, они иногда действительно помогают нам проходить что-то, помогают нам делать следующий шаг. Но знаешь, когда песня поднимается внутри нас, с этим ничего не может сравниться. Тогда устанавливается связь с нашим Небесным Отцом, с нашим Творцом, и все изменяется вокруг. Поэтому, где бы ты ни находился сейчас, найди возможность петь вместе с нами, чтобы песня поднималась внутри тебя. Аминь.
Ты с любовью взирал на разбитую жизнь, верным другом ты стал до конца и взял мое бремя. Совершенно любовью оправдал всегда в твоем сердце люблю я прощение. О, как велик тот крест, на нем страдал и победил смерть. Мощный поток благодати распахнул нам врата.
пока я дышу, о ней буду петь. Это все, что так нужно мне. Тебе буду петь, ты смолкну вовек, изумлен я любовью твоей. Пока я дышу, о ней буду
имя.
say thank you to everyone for your contribution to building the church, despite the season that we're all going through. And it seems that it is about to end. But still, there are many people who pray for finances, for financial breakthrough, about provision, that God reveals His ways and blessings in their lives. And you know, no matter what, people continue to sow, people continue to invest, people continue to be faithful to building the house of God, they continue to support what we do for the people around us. And I would like to say thank you again very much for your contribution. I'm most encouraged that there are also so many people that tell their stories of gratitude to God for what He does in such a period. For example, someone got a new job, someone got a promotion, someone got a blessing from those sources that they didn't count on and maybe didn't even know about. You know, I want to encourage you all as well to continue to invest, continue to trust God, because He has heavenly sources, because He is strong, because He is our protector, because He provides for us. Let's continue to sow and hope. I believe that God will answer, not according to what we give, but according to our faith, when we remain faithful and generous in His house, His calling, His mission in this world. Amen. And now let's prepare our hearts to receive God's word. Record the message at home again, and believe me, I'm waiting for the moment when we can gather together, when I can see people I'm preaching to. That is why today I'm hoping for this message to reach someone it is addressed for. It will be an encouragement, something important you need to hear from God. Let's pray together. Let's take the Bibles, if you have them. Let's pick them up and pray together. Dear Lord, thank you for your mercy and goodness. Thank you for every person who is watching this message. Lord, today on Sunday, we pray, bless them with the word that they need. It will build their faith, it will reprove, rebuke, and make us better. Build our spirit from within. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen. 2 weeks ago, I preached about faith. Today, I also would like to talk about faith. And when we're under some pressure, due to different circumstances around, when something is wrong, your faith is tested. Our life depends on faith. Our relationship with God, our life, righteous life depends on how we walk in faith, our righteous and holy life, because we can live this way only by faith. We receive grace from God only by faith. And 2 weeks ago, I preached about faith from the book of James. I really like what he says about faith. He says that faith is tested and tempered due to difficulties. Wow! That means bad things in life help our faith to grow and become persistent and mature. And today I would like to draw your attention to another author who writes about faith. Apostle Peter in the New Testament. If James speaks about maturity of faith, then Peter talks about faith from another point of view. He talks about the practical part of faith, about how it is manifested in our everyday life. And so, today I called my message «My Faith on Monday». You can write it down if you take notes. «My Faith on Monday». Usually, our Sundays are full of faith. Why? Because we are in the church service or connected to the online service. But what happens on Monday? Today I would like to challenge us as Hillsong Church. Let's also fill our Mondays with faith. Faith in God. Expectation of God, expectation of miracles on Mondays, when we're at work, when we're on the road, when we're around family, when we are out in the world. And let's read together what Peter writes in 2 Peter chapter 1, Петра, verses 4 to 9.
С 4 по 9 стихи. Которым дарованы нам
великие драгоценные обетования,
дабы через них
соделались причастниками божеского естества, удалившись от господствующего в мире растления похоти, то вы прилагаете все старания получить в вере вашей добродетели, добродетели рассудительности, рассудительности воздержания, воздержания, терпения, терпения, благочестия, здесь уже. Are you with me? Verse 7. And to godliness, mutual affection, and to mutual affection, love. For if you possess this qualities in increasing measure, they will keep you from being ineffective and unproductive in your knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. But whoever does not have them is nearsighted and blind, forgetting that they have been cleansed from their past sins. Peter says that we have powerful promises from God, and by faith they can be part of our lives, by faith in Jesus Christ. But he also says that we need to make efforts so that besides faith, some things are manifested in our life. So when people say, I don't want to talk about faith, faith is something personal, and this is what I have inside. It is true, we have faith inside in our heart, but listen, when faith is really in our heart, to be precise, when we really believe in something in our heart, it will always manifest itself on the outside. So we need to speak about our faith. Yes, faith is inside, but it is visible on the outside. And it can be seen in the way we live in the middle of the week, in our actions on Monday. And what Peter writes here has not so much to do with church on Sunday, but with our real life on Monday. And this is what I would like to talk about. But there is a small problem. We read this passage, large passage from the Bible, and Peter writes here about these things in the way as they spoke 2,000 years ago. It's the way people expressed their thoughts. They gave such long lists of what follows what. But when we read it all, the problem is that we don't remember anything and don't understand how we actually need to live. It's amazing that Peter was one of the key people in the New Testament church. And we only have two of his short messages. But when we read the message of Peter, you know, it's not a poetry book. This is like the book of Proverbs. And as someone said once, that the book of Proverbs cannot be read quickly because you will miss all the main things. It is important to read the message of Peter slowly. I'll explain what I mean. Let's read verses 5 to 7 again. For this very reason, make every effort to add to your faith goodness, and to goodness knowledge, and to knowledge self-control, and to self-control perseverance, and to perseverance godliness. And to godliness, mutual affection, and to mutual affection, love. Mutual affection is basically what I would like to speak about today. Amen? Be blessed. Nobody understood anything? So how should this be reflected in my daily life? That's why we need to read slowly. We need to reflect on what he said. I hope that today you can get something for yourself. Are you ready? Let's look at this word by word. In the beginning he says, make every effort to add to your faith, goodness. It means, and this is a figure of speech that was used 1,000 years ago, besides faith, show also goodness. It means faith is good. By faith we come to God. Faith is really the most important in our relationships with God. But apart from faith, show also goodness. Faith in Jesus encourages each of us to ministry and to sacrifice. So when people tithe, when people are ready to serve voluntarily for the benefit of other people, listen, it's not like these people are forced. These people want to do this because it is the way our faith manifests itself. Faith inside is manifested on the outside. It's something we want to do. We shouldn't just do these things without faith inside. We shouldn't serve other people or give when we have no faith inside.
Потому что вера, которая внутри, побуждает нас это делать, и мы хотим. Наша вера внутри выражается в том, насколько мы
И у меня вопрос. And I have a question. How you can serve people on Monday? How can I and all of us serve people on Monday when we're not at a church meeting and even right now on the online meeting? I believe that serving others can be described as follows. Serving others begins when our responsibilities end. Think about it. Serving begins when our responsibilities end.
И я еще раз повторюсь, это не то, что мы должны, это то, что мы делаем добровольно.
Я хотел бы бросить сегодня вызов нашей церкви. Our church today.
Делай
do a little
немного
more
больше,
than you should.
Чем ты должен.
Делай немного больше, чем ты должен.
Пусть в этом проявляется твоя вера на работе,
at work,
когда тебя что-то попросили сделать, когда...
When we
все,
do anything in our life
жизни,
as unto God,
пусть
let your faith in Jesus be complemented by such an attitude in your everyday life. Amen.
And
do your best.
Matthew 5, verse 41.
If anyone forces you to go 1 mile, go with them 2 miles.
Вторая миля – это часть культуры
Second mile
церкви Hillsong.
Is a part of
Но в первую очередь
culture.
Это культура Божьего Царства.
But first of all, it is the culture of God's kingdom. Amen. Do a little more than you are asked to do. A little more than you should. Jesus did more than he should for you.
Больше, чем он должен был. Никогда
Never forget
не
about that.
Поэтому
Faith is not about doing the
minimum
in our lives.
Жизни, что я должен сделать? Нет, это всегда
It's always about maximum.
Максимума. Что
What else can I do?
Еще могу сделать? И, честно,
And to be honest,
я всегда
I always tried to be like that in the ministry.
И когда-то я
And once I have decided
я,
that when somebody asks
просят,
me for something,
и если
if
я говорю,
I say yes,
я буду
I will
это делать,
do it as for
pastors
Brian and Bobby.
Потому
Just
что мы их
love them,
мы их почитаем,
respect them, but what kind of,
какой жизнью они живут,
for the kind of life they live and how they shepherd Hillsong Church around the world. But I decided that I will serve people as I would serve them, because the heart of serving can't be episodic. It's a lifestyle. It manifests itself in all situations. Amen. Let's continue to look at what Peter says.
Петр, в
goodness, knowledge.
Далее Петр
so
говорит,
Peter says,
дополните
to your ministry,
дополните
добродетель, goodness,
дополните
and
свои
add
добрые
knowledge.
Дела также рассудительностью. И что
Whatever
бы ты ни делал,
do,
я верю, во всем нужна мудрость
wisdom.
В каждом деле. Важно
it is important
не забыть
to remember
и не упустить
why you do
причину,
it,
почему
the reason
ты
why you
это
do it.
Делаешь. И я хочу бросить еще один вызов
as a church,
тебе,
once again.
Нам как церкви.
Why do you do the familiar things during the week?
We
do a lot of familiar things in life, usual things, but remember why you do it, whatever it is. If it's God ministry or work, or is it some usual thing at home, remember the reason. Vanity sometimes kills desire. I saw many times when among believers who made wise and important decisions in favor of God, vanity would kill, take away, exhaust their desire to serve God. Their passion in the beginning. When I remember why I do it and for whom I do it, that helps me to continue to serve God, continue to serve people. I do not want to do anything in life, especially serving God, forgetting why I do it. The problem of many people is that they just do without reasoning why. I believe that this is why religiousness occurs or some religious deeds. When we do something, but we don't even understand what is behind it. For me personally, the reason why I serve to God and to people is Jesus. Because He served, He came to serve. He said, I am here to serve you, not for you to serve me. And one of the aspects of faith
Да, верой мы приходим
yes,
к Богу.
By faith we come to God. By faith we see the work of God in our lives and in the lives of people. But one of the aspects of faith is a projection or reflection of life of Jesus Christ in our daily routine, in our deeds. Reflection or projection of His attitude towards people is our attitude towards people today. Therefore, often I ask myself a question. Maybe it may seem an obvious small question, but I really think about what would Jesus do if He was at my place when I go to work in a car, when I find myself in a huge traffic jam. What would He do if He was in self-isolation? What would Jesus do at my place? And it helps us to be more like Him, or at least possibly stop us from some wrong things. Was it reasonable to sacrifice the life of Jesus for the good of others? You know, all the wisdom of the Bible is in this. But He said it's better to give than to take. It is really a blessing, and it enriches. It will enrich your life. Further, Peter says to knowledge self-control. In other words, add something else to wisdom and knowledge. Add self-control. I think that he really talked about all these things based on personal experience, and he learned self-control. Many people look at this word or generally at the principle of self-control in the context of Christian faith in the wrong way. Why? Because they think it means suppressing one's feelings, emotions, and desires. But if it really was so, we would not be able to live a life of abundance. Think about it. Because self-control in a Christian and biblical context, it's not just suppressing yourself or suppressing some of your desires or feelings and so on. No, it means submitting them to God. And it is completely different thing when we choose not our will, but God's will. When we perhaps choose God's ways, and not our own ways, when we choose God's wisdom and not our own wisdom. That is why Christian way of life is when Jesus Christ is the Lord of my life and the King in every area of my life, in my heart. So I would like to challenge us as a church. Let us add to the things we've spoken about our faith on Monday so that there is less of me and more of God. Once I realized that the biblical fasting is best expressed by this phrase, less of me and more of God. But now I want to say it's more like what the true Christian life should be when there is less of me and more of God. Amen. In the Gospels, we see Peter, who was rather unrestrained. He constantly offered Jesus his ideas that didn't work for him, which were often, well, let's say, not so good. But in the book of Acts, we see a completely different Peter, when he had more Christ in him than that Peter of the past. And it is the goal is for each one of us. And then in his epistle, he writes that we should also have self-control in us because it is the thing that we can learn and practice. Philippians chapter 3, verse 8, it's how Apostle Paul writes about it. What is more, I consider everything a loss because of the surpassing worth of knowing Christ Jesus my Lord, for whose sake I have lost all things. I consider them garbage, that I may gain Christ. This is what it means to have less of me and more of God in my life. How do you do that so that on Monday there would be less of me and more of God? For His sake, I refuse some things, some thoughts, or some wrong attitude. Jesus abandoned some things because of you. And when we do the same, it draws you so much closer to Him and increases God in our life, everyday life. The next thing, it says, and to self-control, perseverance. Again, Peter talks about the thing he learned in his life with God. It's perseverance. Each one of us needs perseverance. Amen. Sometimes we don't see a greater result, not because of the wrong faith, but because of the lack of perseverance in our faith. One of the first lessons I learned after I turned 30, because after I turned 30, I had two amazing daughters, it's patience. We need patience in our life. Patience is very important in our homes. Amen. We need to persevere to move forward, to continue sowing in the things you believe. Amen. Not just sit passively and wait when God does all the work for us. No, but to be persevering in how we keep moving forward. I want to challenge our whole church. It is what I say to myself quite often. Don't give up too soon. Don't give up too soon. I noticed that we all often give up too quickly on people. How do we do that? When we are too quick to draw conclusions and judgments about them, you understand what I am talking about? For example, you could have made hasty conclusions about Peter when he began to sink while trying to walk on water, or when he cut an ear to one of the warriors who had come to arrest Jesus, or when he offered to burn Samaria with fire, or when he denied Jesus three times. You know, we all could have made some hasty conclusions and could have written lots of comments in social media about Peter. But that's not what Jesus did. Listen, one could have drawn a hasty conclusion about each one of us, but let us believe in people. In other words, believe in their God-given potential and let us continue to water with our kind words of faith, thankfulness, mercy, and hope. Let us not give up too early on people. Amen. Let's consider three other things Peter says. I have only 5 or 7 minutes left. And to perseverance, godliness. 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 5. Having a form of godliness, but denying its power, have nothing to do with such people. Apostle Paul writes, I remember when I was a young pastor, I was a youth pastor at that time, a guy came to me with whom we had a very good personal relationship, and because he trusted me, he decided to ask me a question about what he was going to do in the nearest future, so that I shared my opinion about whether I thought it was a good thing to do. I listened to him, I said, I didn't think it would be good. We spoke for a long time, and he started to explain me that perhaps it looked or it was some sort of compromise, but he would do all he could so that it would not lead to sin. So we talked for a long time, but finally he still made the same decision and did what he had planned from the very beginning, simply without my blessing. And at the very end, he said, I would do my best so that it would not lead to sin. Don't worry about that. And I replied to him that you don't need to look for a border of sin in your life, but you need to choose and seek such a way of life that will honor God you believe in. Amen? We all need to choose such ways and such actions that will honor God, our Father in heaven. Amen? To choose the things that will honor God is one more challenge I want to throw out to all of us precisely regarding our everyday life. How to build such a relationship before the marriage that will not only keep from sin, but will honor God. This summer, we're going to have a few church weddings. It's always a great time. I am always glad to perform a wedding ceremony. But listen, a church wedding is not just a moment of blessing, as lots of young people see it. It's not just a moment of God's blessing. It's the moment of our honoring God with our life, the way we lived and came to this moment when we bring our life to an altar and say, God, we honor you and your words by our relationship and our life, and we also ask you to bless our family, our marriage, and our future, and to be in it. Amen. Next thing, in godliness, mutual affection. Even when we try to honor God with our life, Peter says, complemented with good attitude, love to close people, your family, your church. I noticed that sometimes it's easier for us all to love people who are far from us, to write some good, kind words and show mercy to people who are somewhere far away. Or to some people we don't even know, it's easier just to share our thoughts or express something in social media, write some comment, but it's a completely different thing when we treat our close people like that. And I want to challenge us as a church to be kind and merciful to our close people and those people who we come across most often. Perhaps it's most difficult to show kindness and mercy to these people, but let us first of all do it in our families, with the closest people, in our home and in our spiritual home. And one more thing. And to mutual affection, love. Peter concludes his long thought that the faith in Jesus should grow not in a religious spirit, but it should transform into love. That is the main commandment that we read in the Bible about, that Jesus taught. It incites us to be a blessing for others, to be the Christians and the church that the world really needs. And I would like to express it in the following way, so that it would be a challenge for you and for us. Do with gladness the things that will benefit others and not you. Think about it. Write it down. I want to encourage you to write it down and to think about it, not just to think about it, but to do something about it. Do with gladness the things that will benefit others and not yourself. Last Sunday, Pastor Kirill said that natively there is no thankfulness in his children. It is the thing we need to learn and to practice in order to understand. The things we've spoken about are also the things you need to practice in order to understand. We need to practice faith to know God. We don't need to try to understand God with our mind, but we need to practice our faith in real life in order to know God in all our ways. Amen. Do it with gladness for the benefit of others. I want to throw out a challenge to every person in our church. Perhaps it will be kind of a so-called challenge. You know, different challenges are very popular now in social media, when somebody throws out a challenge and everybody repeats it. But I'm sure that this challenge is not going to be very popular here on this earth. It's not going to be popular in social media, no, but it is going to be known and, I believe, very popular in heaven. Let's do something for another person that you would really want for yourself. Give somebody something important and valuable as a present that you would want to have for yourself. Perhaps when you make some money, buy for a person you value in your life just the same stuff you would want for yourself. Or perhaps give as a present something you have and what other person needs, something really valuable for you. Annie and I gave a present, really valuable things, and we constantly do it from time to time for the people around us. We give as a present something that we have, and we know that this person needs it, and even though we aren't going to have it anymore, for us, it's a great joy to share our life or what we have in our life for the benefit of others. Proverbs chapter 11, verse 24 says, one person gives freely, yet it gains even more. Another withholds and dulls, but comes to poverty. You know, love can never be greedy, and also love can never make your life smaller. If we have all those things in our life, as Peter writes at the end, and they multiply, you will not be left without fruit. But if not, he says, in that case, we can even miss those blessings that are right around the corner, that are right here, so close to us, we're just not going to see them. I believe what Peter said wasn't just a theory, but he shared his personal experience from his life, and also those things that he had seen in the life of Jesus, because he had spent quite a lot of time with him when he was here on earth. Had Peter had those qualities when he started following Jesus? I think no. Or not all of them.
А возможно, никакая из них не
That's
была
for sure. Perhaps he didn't have Но some of them, but he was learning them while following Jesus. He was learning those things by practicing them. He was learning them perhaps by seeing them in the life of Jesus and then trying to do the same things in his life, which later on started to bring great fruit in his life and ministry, and I believe in his family.
Это был путь, это его рост, это его решение.
It was his path, his way of growing, his decision, and these are the things we all need to grow in. That's why I want to throw out a challenge to our church one more time. Let us make sure we fill our Mondays with faith when we're at work, when we're on the road, when we're with the family, when we're in this world. And may your faith on Monday be alive and effective in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. I hope you have received these words into your heart. I also really hope this message will have a continuation in people's lives during the week. And also, that our faith is manifested in various circumstances at work, at home, that will influence other people in the name of Jesus Christ. I also wanted to pray a simple prayer with every person who would like to accept Jesus. If you never made a conscious decision to let Jesus into your life as your Lord and Savior, I want to offer you to pray with me right now. Wherever you are, just be yourself. You can trust your life to God right now. What do we do for this? We believe that Jesus is God's Son. We also believe that He went to the cross for our sins, cleanse our sins. Because the Bible says God loves every person but cannot enter our lives because of sins. Therefore, everyone needs Jesus, and for each of us, it's important to believe in what He did for us on the cross. If you would like to pray this prayer, let's pray right now with me. Repeat after me, but make this prayer your own. Close your eyes if it's comfortable for you, and repeat after me. Dear Heavenly Father, I come to you. I confess that I'm a sinner, and I need a Savior. I believe that God's Son, Jesus Christ, went to the cross and died for my sins. I also believe that He rose on the third day to give me a new life. You are my Lord and you are my Savior. And from this day, my life will never be the same. I also believe that I will see you in heaven. We prayed in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. I am very happy for you if you really pray this prayer. We congratulate you on behalf of Hillsong Church, and we will be happy to contact you, congratulate you, pray for you, and we have a small gift for you. And I would like to ask, if it's not difficult for you, to leave your contact information on our website, and first of all, to let us know about this important decision you've made to let Jesus into your heart. I believe that your life really will never be the same again, and the best is yet to come. To the entire church, I want to say that we love you and miss you very much, and we pray that God's protection and God's wisdom is in your life, and God's grace is with you at work, at home, in relationships. And I want to wish everyone a great next week and the best Sunday, and see you soon on our live stream. I was running wild, fell in love with the chase.